hanging with her.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to Hanging with Herb. This is a time where I hang out and have candid conversation with some of my valued friends. Today, I welcome a former general manager of the California Angels and the current executive vice president of baseball and softball development for Major League Baseball. But notably, most notably, he's a member of the Indy Ohio Hall of Fame, Tony Reagins. How you doing, Tony?
Hey, good to be with you, Herb. Make sure you made that note of
the Hall of Fame.
I know that's a sore spot with you, so yeah.
No, I don't have a problem with that. I left many records there, but I'm going to move on. And, you know, we're not going to linger on that for sure. Hey, all right. Always start off by talking about us, how we know each other. Number one, you were and are my younger cousin, and used to be younger kid cousin, but now has kind of grown up a little bit. And our grandmothers, Cora, your grandmother, Fanny, my grandmother, the McGee sisters, our sisters, and that's how we're related. We go back to Indio, where you got the sign right there, Indio. We've been at the Boys Club, We've done church. You were Second Baptist, I was First Baptist, and we just had a great time. Talk a little bit about your time in Indio.
No, that's, you know, that was the time. Those were some of the greatest moments of my life. When you look back at those times and when you're going through it, you know, it seems so boring and it seems so hot and you couldn't wait to get out of there. But now, you know, as you grow up and you get more mature and you go through life, you can't wait to get back. So it's funny how it goes full circle. And, you know, the importance of your childhood and development stages in life, the impact that Indio and the Coachella Valley in general had on my life and yours, you know. That's
some good times. All right, now talk a little bit about you. I don't know this part, so I'm going to ask you. Start with your birth city, and then talk about your high school, college, and kind of bring it up to present.
Birth city, so, you know, born right there in Indio, right behind me on my shoulder. Okay. You know, we grew up there. You know, my mom, and, you know, obviously my dad passed away when we were young, 4 years old, and then. Grew up in Indio with my brother and two sisters. And again, like I said, those were some of the most important times in my life in terms of development and family and really becoming, you know, the person that you ultimately become. Indio was a main factor in all of that. Then you go through life, you go to high school and you do what you do in high school. And you know what I did in high school.
Talk a little bit about what you did in high school there.
Well, you know, athleticism there was legendary, and I think I still have a couple of football records there. It's funny that, you know, I was a better football player than I was a baseball player, but my career path ended up being in baseball, which is, you know, ironic. My brother is obviously a better baseball player, or was a better baseball player than me, Danny, but. The game, I was always around the game. And so Indy, Ohio was a place where, we learned how to play the game. We had great coaches that were impactful in our lives, not just on the field, but off the field. And then you graduate, and I went out to College of the Desert for a couple of years and got a few degrees there that I thought were important at the time. And, you know, you continue to mature and continue to grow. And for me, I hadn't left home. Going to College in the Desert, which is right down the road, I'm still, you know, a local guy. And then I make the move to Orange County, which was another eye-opening experience. And the only reason why I went to Orange County was because of my brother, Danny. And my brother-in-law, David. They both went to Cal State Fullerton, and so I followed suit.
I need to.
I know you went to Cal State. I don't know if you graduated, but I know you went.
Stop then. I had a cup of coffee. Don't worry about that, though.
Hey, it's the difference between going and graduating. So.
There's two different things going on there.
Yeah, so there's a little difference there. But I thought that part of my – at the time, the decision was purely because of Danny and David. And then, you know, I go there and, you know, I pledge a fraternity and – you know, we just the other day lost our frat brother, John Lewis, which was, you know, obviously tragic. And, you know, his impact on the nation is legendary. Yes. But I go to Cal State Fullerton and get a degree in marketing. And upon my graduation, a good friend of mine, Kevin Van, basketball referee.
Yeah.
Kevin. Yeah. He told me about it was probably days after my graduation. He was telling me about an internship that the Angels were doing. And I didn't know anything about it. He said, man, let's go down there and check it out. And so I walk in there with Kevin. We suited up and ready to go. We figured we at least got to look good, you know. So we go down there. And, man, we walk into the press box. I'll never forget, man. We walk in there, and there's like 300 people in this press box. Just packed in the press box, all looking for 10 internships. And, again, blessed and, you know, God's favor really on me that, you know, I was selected one of the 10 out of those 300. And, you know, really my career took off from there. Started at the Angels in an unpaid free internship.
Unpaid.
Unpaid. So sometimes you got to pay your dues, but worked there for 2 years unpaid. And, you know, I look back at that. The only way I made it was basketball refereeing, man. I would, you know, work during the day. And then as soon as 6 o'clock, jump on the freeway and get to a basketball game. and all of that because you helped pay some of my bills that, from reffing those games. And so you just look at the journey, man, over time. You go through life and, you know, it's filled of ups and downs and zigs and zags, but you have to navigate that and you have to persevere because, you know, no matter what, you got to come through the other side. And you never know what the other side is going to look like unless you go through it.
That's true. So,
you know, that was me and my journey, man. I started there in 1991 and, you know, 17 years later, I ended up, you know, running the club, which is, you know, it is historic. I'm the only, you know, African-American in the history of the game that started as an intern, didn't play professionally,
wow,
ended up running the major league club. So, you know, that part of, you know, my journey is, you know, unprecedented in a lot of ways, but you know, at the end of the day, you know, you still are, your family is first. You know, I have a great family, great supportive wife and kids, and you can't do it without great family. So, you know, my brother and sister have been with me along the way, and, you know, and obviously you and our extended family has always been important. So, you know, I look back at all of this, the success that I've had and been fortunate and blessed to have, it's because of, you know, family and the way we were raised.
Absolutely. Absolutely. I definitely employed you as a ref for my league and paid you handsomely. I also allowed you to sleep on my couch several nights, free of charge, never charged you a dime for that, ate some of my food and that kind of a thing. So I appreciate you bringing that into the conversation. It's very important.
Again, I'll give credit where credit is due. Every once in a while, you did, you didn't, but Charlotte might have cooked a meal or two. And yeah, I know you didn't. But, you know, I just look back at those days when you and Charlotte lived back in Orange County and we used to get together and play cards and dominoes and spades. And the family continued, right? That was, to me, that was real family where, you know, every weekend we were all together. I mean, we were all fully grown adults, but every weekend, I mean, we were together, you know, and in those times, you know, sometimes you yearn for that. You yearn for that experience and that connection, because it just doesn't exist every day. It's something that obviously we were able to share and was really important in all of our lives.
All of our lives, absolutely, absolutely. Talk a little bit about the boys and girl, the boys club in Indio. You came up through there. I was talking to Dave Eisen the other day and just reminiscing on how much I learned, how much it shaped my life going there to the boys club every day.
Yeah, it did. It I think what and both me and Danny, you know, I think what was really important was like those guys, you know, Dave and Charlie Turan, and those guys were like our father figures. You know, obviously our dad died when we were young, and you know, they didn't care if we were black, white, red, yellow, polka dot. They embraced us. You know, Grady Gordon, you know, those guys embraced us. They took care of us. My mom would allow us to go on trips, you know, with them. So she trusted them, which was huge. And, you know, I had some of my, you know, greatest experiences and some of my toughest experiences, life experiences at the Boys and Girls Club too. At that time, it was just the Boys Club.
Yes.
And, you know, I look at that time, you look forward to going every single day because that's where all your friends were. And I would come right after, I would walk over there from Wilson School over to across the freeway there and get over to the Boys Club. And I just remember I would always be hungry after getting over there. And so in order to eat, we would read a book. So you had to read crackers or chips. And so that's what, you know, that's what the plan was. You go read a book, eat some crackers and chips, and then you're good for a little bit. And so I just look back at those times, and you know, the Boys and Girls Club was truly important in my life and my, you know, my maturity and my adulthood. You know, I'm on the board of directors locally at the Boys and Girls Club in Coachella Valley, and then I'm on the national board of directors, so for the country as well. And okay. The reason why I'm on those boards are because of my upbringing. And I just appreciate what the Boys and Girls Club has been able to do and what they continue to do. Quentin Nexon is doing a good job down there. You know, he's the CEO down there in Indio now. And so the legacy continues, and, you know, a lot of great work still being done. And, you know, we support it, you know, both in person and financially as well, because it's important and they change lives.
Absolutely. All right. What we're going to do now is we're going to hit a few pictures here, take a look at some pictures that, and let's talk me through them. Number one, I think we have here is your family.
Yeah. So, I mean, you got us in various stages. There we are in the Bahamas, I think, down there. Yeah, that's a cool picture. And then one of the first times we were in New York, at my father-in-law's birthday party.
Okay.
I think one of these is Christmas over there on the right. In the middle, Steph hadn't been born yet, so that was early on at our new house in Yorba Linda.
Oh, that was Yorba Linda, okay.
Yeah, and then that one on the far left is at church. I don't remember what that one's for, but all good times. But, you know, again, like I said before, man, family is what's most important, and, you know, is the reason why we do what we do.
Absolutely. Now, here's some more. This is you and your lovely wife.
Yeah.
Now, the one the one on the top left, I remember distinctly. I was in Arizona, wasn't it, on one of your birthdays?
Yeah, she made you a cake, I think.
No, she made you a cake. And I had to eat it. Yeah, I hope she's gotten better since then.
she's a wonderful, wonderful cake maker. And you enjoyed it. I think you had to have some milk with it, but
I had to have a gallon of milk, but hey.
It was all good. I mean, these pictures, obviously the memories are great memories. You know, different times and moments in our lives, and you know, having the, you know, some with like, no, all the kids there. I guess there's one down there with Seth not in it. Yeah. And there he is in the corner. So
no,
great memories, man. Great memories. I think that's one with me as the GM of the Angels in that back corner there. So
now
this is all Angel stuff.
Yeah, this is Angel stuff. When we used to it was just a ritual. Every year we'd go to spring training and take the family. And man, those were some of the greatest times when we'd all get together. This one on the top left was 1993. That was early on.
Early on. And you know what? You know, you would never ask for like two tickets to the game or four tickets to the game. I mean, you used to come and ask for 10.
I mean, yeah, like one. No, you wouldn't want one or two. Well, I got 5 kids, so, you know, and I got a wife, so that's 7. And, you know, I always got 2 or 3 friends.
Yeah, so, I mean, that was a great time. And having the family together and everybody coming down, you look forward to those times. And, you know, great memories, man.
Just great memories. Great memories. Now, this will take you back to your boys' club days. Your Keystone Club. The one in the middle here is me and Charlie Tribble and Ronald Johnson, and we all were headed to the Grand Canyon back then. And just all these great pictures of the guys, and our cousin in the middle, Al Walls, who is.
Dominate. Out and punt, pass, and kick.
Dominate punt, pass.
Dominated, yeah. That one in the top right is, so as the Keystone Club, we won the national award in the Keystone Club at the Boys and Girls Club National Convention. And look at me in my white suit and brown, you know, getting it in.
Right, all right. Yeah, you're gonna be clean. You're clean. and then down in the bottom left are the two men that I give a whole lot of credit for who I am today. My varsity head coach in the red, Paul Thompson, and then the director of the boys club in the blue, Dave Eisen. Two men that just are so important to a lot of these boys in these pictures and many, many more. You know, the effect they've had.
Yeah, I think you're right. I mean, Coach Thompson, and I was younger. When he actually, his last year, I was a freshman. And so I didn't play for him at the varsity level.
Okay.
You know, he always treated me with respect and looked after me, even, you know, and I wasn't even his player.
Right.
And then Dave, you know, he's been around and just been so supportive, and again, like a father figure to all of us. You know, it was just really important that we were fortunate that he was in our lives, man, at that, you know, that stage in our life.
Absolutely. Here's some pictures of us at the at the Tony Reagins Boys and Girls Club alumni. The golf tournament. And we have it annually, and we didn't have it this year, but man, we raised a lot of money for.
Yeah, we've been able to do really well with the golf tournament. We were going to go into our 9th year this year. COVID got us this year. We'll be back next year, and. You know, the importance of that is, you know, just giving back to the desert, to the Boys and Girls Club, and giving, you know, young men and women the opportunity to go to college and provide them with scholarship money so they can go. They already have a desire to go, but, you know, sometimes the economics don't work in their favor. So we've been able to provide funds for them, and that's worked out really well. And again, this would have been year number 9, and, you know, we're looking forward to getting back out there next May.
All right, awesome. Now, this next one you're going to love. You're really gonna love this one.
That's good looking out right there. Now Herb, he didn't. I'm telling y'all, everybody, y'all listening, Herb, he didn't want to give me the MVP trophy, but he had to because I dominated that church softball league so so overwhelmingly. He was forced to give it to me. and it wasn't. He didn't give it to me. He was kicking and screaming when he gave it to me.
Hey man, we had some fun in that church softball league sports fellowship back in the day. Won the championship, and yeah, you etched out. That was very close. I had to give it to you. It was some other people in the running. Don't act like you were the only one in the running. But yeah, great.
And look at that one picture. There's Steve Fulford over there.
I know it. Steve Fulford right there. Yes, sir. We miss him. I think he just had a birthday here recently. Had a birthday here recently. And all right, let's do something. Let's do some rapid fire. And I want you, this one is Finish My Song. Ready? First one. Pass me not.
Oh, gentle savior.
one of these old mornings and it won't be very long.
You look for me and I'll be going on.
Okay. What a friend
we have in Jesus.
All right. What about down at the
cross? My savior died.
Okay. Where he
leads me, I will follow.
All right. I am on the
battlefield.
I could go on and on and on. These are songs that were just boom, beat into us and instilled in us as a kid, and we could just pop them out like they're nothing because we know them. Oh, this is one. having been led as we
believe
by the Spirit of God. Hey,
we moreover.
We more. that was the Baptist what?
Hey, that was our the covenant, you know.
The covenant, the Baptist covenant right there. And you have to repeat that over and over and over.
Every first Sunday. Yeah.
Oh, absolutely. All right, final few questions here, man. These are serious, so think about this. First one, the person I most want to be proud of me is?
The single person?
Yes.
My wife. My wife is probably the one I want to be most proud of me, yeah.
Okay. All right. My favorite teacher / coach that had the most influence in my life?
You know, I'm going to go way back, and it was my fifth grade teacher, Mr. Jordan at Eisenhower Middle School, because he had been Tamara's teacher, he had been Danny's teacher, he had been Pam's teacher, and when I came along, he just knew what to expect out of me, and he treated me in a way that he treated me like I was, you know, somebody. And it was just because of the legacy that was by Pam, Tamara, and Danny. So, Mr. Jordan.
Beautiful. Where do you feel the most at home or at peace?
Where? So where would be back in California? I mean, it's when you have a chance to go back home. I obviously live in New York now, and you know, change and adapting to change is a part of life. But whenever you get that chance to go back home, I think that's where you feel most comfortable. I know whenever I go back to Indio specifically, you know, there's just a comfort level of being there. Every year we go back, you know, obviously you go back too. And it's always like, it never gets old. I remember the last time, and I'll be quick, but the last time I went for the golf tournament, I went back to Nairobi, where we grew up.
Yep.
And I went like early in the morning, like at 7 a.m. because we had to be at the golf tournament. So I wanted to drive by and just you know, see it. And so I drove down some of the streets, you know, that we have. And, you know, I drove down Kenya and Liberia. And then you start to see the people kind of waking up and seeing, you know, seeing who you are. And then just having those conversations. So I went to just drive by there for like 10 minutes and ended up standing there for 2 hours, you know, talking to, you know, all the people from the hood. And I still have a hood card, so that was good. And a lot of, you know, just great to be back home. And so that's when I'm most comfortable, when I'm back home.
Beautiful, beautiful. All right, last question, final question. I want my legacy to be?
That I provided and created opportunities for others. That at the end of the day, you know, what we do, you know, you work hard and you try to accomplish what you can. But if you don't provide those same opportunities that I was able to have, then what is it really all about? So if I can create more opportunities for others and give them a chance to achieve success, that's really what it's all about.
Awesome. 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 Well, I want to thank you, Tony, for hanging with Herb today. And in closing, I always honor my parents, Lee and Cree, but I also want to honor your mother, Polly, as well, and encourage us all to unite and give someone a smile. So with that, I'll say Zikomo, which is thank you in Zambia.
All right, Herb, thanks for having me. Man.
Thank you, man. All have right. a great
time. All right. See ya.
Hanging with her.